in some cases of bladder outlet obstruction, the bladder or the urinary tract may break on its own due to the high pressure in the urinary system. This may cause the baby's urine to drain into the belly. This fills up the baby's belly with urine. We call this urinary ascites or urine in the peritoneal or abdominal cavity. Sometimes, urine can leak out into the baby's belly after a bladder tap procedure if the hole in the bladder from the procedure doesn't close. If the hole in the bladder or urinary tract remains open, urine will continue to leak and collect in the baby's belly. The pressure in the belly will continue to increase when more and more urine is filling up. This can push on the baby's internal organs, blood vessels, the diaphragms, and the lungs. The pressure from the urinary ascites can hurt the baby and cause more problems with lung development. To get rid of this high pressure and to improve lung development, we can consider putting a shunt into the baby's belly. A shunt is a way to drain pee or urine out of the baby's belly into the water bag or amniotic cavity. Sometimes, we may first drain the urine out of the baby's belly using a small needle guided by ultrasound before we decide to place a shunt. If the urinary ascites returns quickly, we will consider placing a shunt. Before the shunt is placed, we will put some fluid into the amniotic cavity using a small needle under ultrasound guidance. We then place a trocar directly into the baby's belly. One end of the shunt coils inside of the baby's belly. The trocar is then backed out of the baby, and the opposite end of the shunt is left coiled outside of the baby. The shunt will allow drainage of the urine from the baby's belly into the amniotic cavity before the hole in the bladder or the urinary tract seals off.